make this video happen. Second person I'm gonna tag is none other than Kyublitz. Yeah, I'm tagging you.
Why? Yo, what's up, Carpig? My name is Kyublitz, and welcome to another cat video. It's another year, another cat video. Yes, someone tagged me for another cat video. I have done it yet here, so we're gonna do it again. This year, I was tagged by Quainer Spark. So, check out Quainer Spark if you haven't. And by the way, if you don't know who created this Wonky Battle Cat video, it's Birdkeeper Toby. So check out Birdkeeper Toby. It's like every year game. We have 7 questions this year. Let's get it going. The first question we have is, why do you choose your YouTube name? Like, I can't really explain much. My original YouTube name was Cool Gallo, and we all pretty much know that. If you've been on my channel for a while, you would know it was Cool Gallo. But I decided to change my name from Cool Gallo to Kyublitz just because of the name Cool Gallo. That didn't really sound professional looking sounding, I guess. You're good to find these two words that had no meaning, Cool and Gallo, into one word, and it's just like, it doesn't really make sense at this point. And I decided to change my name from Cool Gallo to Kyublitz because I want to like rebrand myself. I know I went from Cool Gallo to Gallo, then Kyublitz, then Kyublitz. The meaning of the word Kyublitz is a combination of multiple meanings. The word Kyu comes from the Japanese word for Kyu, also meaning rank. So it's like a ranking. Level 1 or level 2, and 2 also means ranking at that specific name. And some part of the world, I think Korea or something like that, 2 also means star. The other reason I put 2 as my name is also because Q-Ranger. If you don't know me by now, I write a lot of Super Sentai. Super Sentai is the Japanese version of Power Rangers. I know this is not Pokemon, but that's where part of my name comes from. Q-Ranger is like space theme Power Ranger, so it fits. It's also based on Kyubey, which is an anime cat-like character from Madoka. And I know a lot of people don't like Kyubey, but there's a deep meaning why I choose Kyubey. It's not because, oh, it's evil or anything, but it's more of, you are, when you make a YouTube channel and work hard on it, you're pretty much giving your soul on working on your YouTube stuff. If you talk to any content creators and stuff like that, you would know that they spend a lot of their time on their videos. It pretty much takes up a lot of their goal because they're wasting their time or just wasting their life on YouTube. But the next question we have is, what's your favorite Pokemon game? My actual favorite game would have to be Diamond and Pearl, just because it's like the game that got me into Pokemon. I started playing Pokemon with Fire Red and Leaf Green, and I couldn't really get into Pokemon with Fire Red and Leaf Green. But when I got Pokemon Diamond and Pearl, I got into Pokemon so much because of that game. And it's like my childhood at this point. That's where the starting region I would consider myself as. My favorite account for that region is Giveaway because I was the theme song for Giveaway City. I would like listen to it, just get there and listen to it while I do like arc up or something like that. It's like calming, but it's so catchy. I love it. I love Giveaway City theme song. But that's the reason why I like Diamond Pearl. I also like Pokemon Ranger. They need to remake that again. The next question is, what is your favorite evil king? Hi. Don't really have a favorite evil king. King Magua maybe? Just because it's just like I like the... No... King Plasma? No. Galactic is actually pretty cool because the boss... Okay. I might go with Galactic, I think. But I also like King Soul. Because there's a goofball and I just like there with the goofball. I like Guma. Guma is like... Big brother of the group, so it's like so cool and stuff like that. They're not really a king, but they're just more like a little gang over here, like, oh, this is my brother and sister, we like support each other. We're like buddies and all that, which is kind of cool. They support one another. I don't see that with any other team, to be honest. I would say King Soul would be my favorite. What sort of viewer expect from you this year? I know a lot of people might not like this idea, but it's for my content and want to do stuff that I like. Are we still doing Pokemon like Pokemon Y, Green, Sleep World, and stuff like that? Maybe call can go out there. I'm not gonna do solo Wrestling because I could never get into solo Wrestling. But if I ever do Wrestling with on my channel, it will be with other people, like gaming, right, or any other thing. Because I like doing Wrestling with other people, it's so much more fun to have people to talk to and interact with. Doing it alone could bore me, so I just won't do solo LP. But the main thing that I'm gonna do on my channel is I will start be doing more non-Pokemon content, which is mostly anime. The reason why I wanna do anime is just because I wanna do other type of content that is not so heavy onto one type of genre. Because anime, I could do so much more things. I could do anime memes, I could do cartoon anime, I could do so many stuff. Yeah, I won't be so limited anymore. Like, I don't have to be so limited to, to do this and that all. But when I had anime as well, I could do so much. I could work with more people. Like, for example, I have an anime YouTube right now. And his name is Kayla Gama, and he is amazing. And start inviting me to, like, hey, you could do more anime content as well, because he thinks that doing one content like Pokemon kinda good for me. I would say it could still for me after a while. But you guys could, there's still gonna be Pokemon, don't get me wrong, but I'm gonna do a lot of non-Pokemon content, you know? But the next question we have is, why do you start this channel? I think the reason why I start this channel, the reason why I want to start my own channel is because I want to make Pokemon content like everybody else. I saw like Game Boy Blue and them, and I got into it. I was like, I want to be like them. I want to make content like them. I see them, I was like, wow, I want to be like them. There's another reason why. If I'm doing Pokemon content, it's because of my disability. I'm deaf, I got facial deformity, we all know that. I want to be the person to represent other people with the same issue as me. I want deaf people to get more involved with the YouTube community. I want to represent them and be like, hey, you guys could do the same thing as everybody else can. There's nothing that could stop you from making the stuff you want to do. There's nothing that could stop you doing what you want to do. Disability don't count because you could do whatever you want. That could put your mind into doing the stuff you want to do, and you will eventually be successful with it. So that's why I start doing content to represent other people with the same disability as me. Name someone with similar or less subscriber you think your audience would enjoy. The people that you could cut out are amazing content creators, and they are Peekaboo. Peekaboo is amazing. Like, cut out Peekaboo. Like, he is very energetic. He's awesome. Cut him out. Go to Guy. I don't even know what his channel name is now. It might be Duck Rebile. It might be King Rebile. But I have the description people for him. He's a good video editor, but he's so small, and it's just like, why is no one checking out Gat? His content is amazing. He edits really good. People need to check his channel out. You also check out gaming, because gaming is also like underrated. Like, check out gaming. He's a good content creator as well. So like, check him out. We might be doing video together. Me and gaming, we had ideas to do video together. So cat came out as well. He's just starting to learning how to edit with me. So he's gonna make good edited videos as soon as like real human. I'm so excited for gaming. I have to catch 3 more people. So I'm gonna catch 3 people that I think could be a part of it. Number 1, I wanna catch Yonker Gay or Crow Bikini. And the reason why is because he's like a friend of mine, and I never really seen him to do a cat. So I want him to do the cat as well. So thank you, Gay. The next person I want to cat is Super Pokin. You don't know who Super Pokin is. He's very small, but I would say he's actually like an upcoming content creator that people could check out. Super Pokin, I'm gonna guide you here, so you better do the cat as well, please, Super Pokin. The next person I'm gonna cat, the final person, is Cat. Hi, Cat. You want me to tell you something? I want you to do the cat as well. So it's 3:30 a.m. They said that you need to cat 3 people, okay? But I want to cat one more person, by the way. And it's Alpha the Wind. Hello, Alpha the Wind. Yeah, it's 3:30 a.m. And I was like, I could add one more person while editing my video. Ha ha ha. Do the video now. Cut out all these people that I cut with it. They're all amazing. Cut them out, you know. You know how I can cut them all out. Please do that. If you like this video, hit like, subscribe for more. But overall, see you next time.